The UK is joining the Biden administration in calling on China to release more data on the origins of the coronavirus. The British Prime Minister says the world needs to see all of the data, all of the evidence, to know how the pandemic happened. That's what a team of investigators from the World Health Organization was seeking to find out in Wuhan, China. A spokesman for the group says their report will outline where further data should be shared and where additional studies are needed. And CNN's Nick Paton Walsh joins me now from London. Good to see you, Nick. You spoke with the lead investigator for the research mission to Wuhan. What all did you learn?
Well, it's important to point out that while that particular mission did, after their press conference last week, receive some criticism for dragging the general narrative closer to the Chinese state media, it's clear from talking to the head of that mission, Peter Ben Embarek, that they also found out quite a lot that they had not known during that particular mission. Key that during December of 2019, when the outbreak first blossomed or grew at a fast rate inside of China, it was wider spread within Wuhan and Hubei than had previously been acknowledged. Important, obviously, to work out where the virus originated from so the world can stop this from happening again. Here's some of the details that Peter Ben Embarek shared with me.
The leader of the WHO mission to China investigating the origins of the coronavirus has told CNN the virus was likely much wider spread in China in December 2019 than was thought. Peter Ben Embarek revealed the 174 positive cases found that first December, likely severe cases, meant there could actually have been an estimated 1,000-plus total cases in and around the city of Wuhan that month.
The virus was circulating widely in Wuhan in December, which I think is a new finding. And the 100 are laboratory confirmed and the 74 are clinically
diagnosed. Confirmed. That 174 would suggest 1,000 or so plus even.
Yeah, probably. Very likely, yeah. Because that's, again, that would fit with all the other parameters that that we have looked at.
The team also established that in that first December, there were as many as 13 slight variations of the virus from samples of all or bits of its genetic code circulating in and around Wuhan, where this seafood market is thought to have played a role.
We have 13 strains covering individuals in December. Some of them are from the market or into the market, some of them are not linked to the market. Though this is something we found as part of our mission.
That many variations so early on could suggest the virus had been circulating for some time, some analysts told CNN, although precise timing is still unclear. Their work heavily scrutinized, tense in frustrating conditions.
Here, remember, we had the entire planet on our shoulders 24 hours a day for a month, which doesn't make the work among scientists easier. Once in a while, you, as always, with between passionate scientists, you get heated discussion and argumentation about this and that.
They hope to return to access biological samples they say China has yet to share, especially hundreds of thousands of blood bank samples from Wuhan dating back 2 years. China's pledged transparency with the investigation.
There is about 200,000 samples in available there that are now secured and could be used for new set of studies.
And you want to look at that urgently?
Yeah, that would be fantastic if we could move with that.
Is it not amazing that they haven't already looked through those samples?
You could say that, but we understand that these samples are extremely small samples and only used for litigation purpose.
So many more questions still to answer. First, if China would let them back in.
Now, China's embassy in the United States has pointed the finger towards the former Trump administration for undermining trust in the WHO. Remember, they pulled out of it and President Biden's jumped back in. But you have to ask yourself, China, with its extraordinary hunger for knowledge, for power, its extraordinary disease surveillance system and medical expertise, how is it possible that for a year they did not look at many of these biological samples, that they did not do some of the testing that it seems the WHO had to ask them to do? These are fundamental questions about China's transparency that will, of course, impact whether or not the WHO get to go back in and continue their investigation. But important to see here, despite all the talk about China covering up or the WHO mission being too close to Chinese sentiments on this, on a government level, they are still, as you can hear there, finding out things they did not know before that may eventually lead to further elucidation of quite how this virus began. Yeah. Rosemary?
Some critical questions there. Nick Paton Walsh joining us live from London. Many thanks.